see me rolling, they hating, patrolling and trying to catch me riding dirty, 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 trying to catch me riding dirty. My music so loud, I'm swinging, they hoping that they gon' catch me riding dirty, trying to 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 catch me riding dirty.
Hey everybody, Jay and Nick, we're back from the 2016 season opener, 10-year anniversary coming up of LeMons at Barber Motorsports Park. Now, Barber is this incredible facility. It has beautiful landscaping, fabulous viewing areas, and we did nothing to crap this place up.
Actually, we kind of did, which is why we gave the I Got Screwed trophy to the Barber groundskeepers.
That is true. We had some great themes.
And we even had a car that was entered by Barber, as in Mr. Barber himself, the owner of the whole track. Now, normally, when we go to these tracks, the owner is off somewhere petting his cat, making you talk to the back of his chair. So, Mr. Barber himself came out, actually got dirty, built a car, and fortunately, we didn't kill him.
Yeah, and I got to yell at him, which was totally fun. One thing I really loved, was these dudes, they brought a new car. It was this horrible CRX. It was just disreputable. I'm talking to the guy. He goes, oh yeah, well, I still got license plates on it. You go, do you drive on the street? Oh yeah, I take my kid to school every day in this car.
She's got to pull zip ties to get that door open. Yeah.
Now, the special award for this race was the Eternal Optimist Trophy, which went to Lunar Lemon and their Chevy Astro minivan. Now, this was a bunch of college kids who were totally and adorably hopeless. They showed up, their roll cage wasn't attached, and they weren't ready, and this, that, and the other. And they had one girl on the team that was kind of the only one who was really organized and trying to make things happen. So she got help from John Pagel, our tech inspector, and she was over there trying to cut spreader plates with like a Dremel tool. And finally, 3 hours before the end of the race, they got it all together, they passed tech, they made it out on track, and that was great.
So the judge's choice went to Apocalyptic Racing and their horrible primered Celica, which we have talked about many times before. So that team and another team, they gave Judge Steve and Judge Dave Montoya, who would have ever thought you'd say that, gave them cars to go out and race against each other. And of course, Dave went flying off the track, got a huge black flag. So he had to come in. We strapped him to the car. He had to apologize to the whole field.
I am a poor example of a human being, let alone a race car driver. I could not pilot a hover round.
That was great, but we figured since those guys lost, I don't know, 2 hours with us dicking around on that thing, we had to give them a trophy.
Organizer's choice went to the Knox Vegas Lowballers. They started out with a Geo Metro, then they decided, well, we'll put a Ford Contour V6 in the back seat of this thing, make it a mid-engine Ford Contour-powered Geo Metro. They had a parts car that was a Contour that had the same engine as the Metro, and then, well, let's race that too. And then they decided, you know, this engine, this Ford Contour engine, is the greatest thing ever. So they took two, and they put one in the front, one in the back of a Mazda MPV minivan and made a twin-engine, twin-transmission, double Ford Contour-powered race car.
And incredibly, they're kind of getting faster and faster and faster and faster to the point where they've started to win races.
Okay, so you guys have probably all seen those Ken Block Gymkhana videos where he takes a cool rally car and he does a bunch of tricks through a abandoned military base or through a city or whatever it is. They're super popular.
So what these guys did, they took their mid-engine Geo, they made it into a kind of dead nuts replica of the Ken Block Fiesta,
and they put a 65 Mustang body on a Ford Contour, and naturally the internet, how could you do that for $500?
It is outrageous.
They put a Mustang on a Contour, and it looked awesome. That's all you need to know.
And then that takes us to the IOE, which was Jay Crude. Now, this was a, as far as I could tell, bone stock, totally hammered, totally soft Jaguar XJ6. And not even a modern XJ6. I mean, not even like from the 80s. I don't know when this thing was made. It was like made in the reign of King George. So this guy, his whole team totally walked out on him like a week before the event. So now there's one dude, terrible car, totally stock. He shows up anyway. He's got khaki pants. He's got a button-down shirt, and he did the entire weekend. He fixed the car, he made the car run, he qualified the car, he teched the car, he drove the car, and you know what? it finished like in the top third. Unbelievable.
He was like, cheerio, mate. Victory.
Here's LeMons in a nutshell.
Another one up, we live it like wings. I got a puff in my right hand, 40 ounce in my left, breeze in my heart. Rolling up the tree, green.